We are going to see the parallel implementation of Floyd's algorithm using MPI. So hope you remember the all pair shortest path problem where you are given a graph with weight on directed edges. So the direct edge represents there is a path existing between the two nodes, and the weight on that particular direct edge represents the distance between them. So we are trying to find out the shortest path between every nodes. As a first step, what we do is we construct an adjacency matrix. The rows will be nodes and the columns will be also nodes. So every cell represents the distance between the row and the column node. Here you can see that the infinity represents a higher value where there is no direct edge from A to that particular any node to that particular node. Given a weighted directed graph, the all pairs shortest path problem is to find out the length of the shortest path between every pair of vertices. So the length of the path is strictly determined by the weights of its edges, not the number of edges traversed. So if you are going to solve this problem, we need to construct the adjacency matrix as the first step. Now, after executing the Floyd's algorithm, what we need to get is this matrix. The adjacency matrix gets updated like this. Now we have the distance between any two pair of nodes, even though it traverses other cities along in this path. So you can see that now we have a value 7 from A to D. You can see that from A to B, it takes around 6 kilometers, and from B to D, it takes around 1 kilometer. So total of 7 kilometers. Likewise, every pair of nodes, the distance between every pair of nodes are updated here. So let's see what is the algorithm. Hope you remember this algorithm also. We have a nested for loop where we have the index for k starting from 0 to n minus 1. Then we will be traversing each element of that adjacency matrix. Here there is only one assignment statement in this nested loop. You can see that every cell is getting updated with the minimum value. Minimum of what? Minimum of two things. One is if there is a value existing in that cell, comma, another path where you traverse along another city, A, I, comma, K, and from K to J. So whichever is the minimum will be updated here in this cell. We will try to execute the Floyd's algorithm, the normal Floyd's algorithm, using this simple graph given here. There are four nodes and we have the weights given here. So this will be the initial adjacency matrix. So what we are going to do is we will execute this Floyd algorithm. So you can see the implementation here. We have the nested loop here, three nested loops and the assignment statement. So let's execute this. Okay. So we'll take our graph here. Okay. Let's execute it. So since in this graph we have four vertices, we'll give it as 4. The number of edges, we have 6 edges. Now we need to give each edge information. So 1 to 2, the distance is 2 kilometers. From 2 to 3, it is 3 kilometers. From 3 to 1, it is 5. 3 to 4, we have 3. Then 2 to 4, we have 4. And again from 4 to 2, we have 2. So this is the result of normal Floyd's algorithm where every distance is updated with the minimum value. You can see that now we have a path from 1 to 3. It is updated as 5. We can go from 1 to 2, then 2 to 3. So this is the execution of the simple Floyd's algorithm. We are going for the parallel implementation of Floyd's algorithm. So the first step will be partitioning. Should we go for domain decomposition or functional decomposition. When you see at the pseudocode, you can see that it is a nested loop of order n cube. And there is only one assignment statement. So there is no functional decomposition possible here. So we are going for domain decomposition. So we have the adjacency matrix, the whole data here, which has to be decomposed into n square elements. So the primary task will be the element in that adjacency matrix. So we will figure out the communication part. Now, you know that when a particular element 3, 4, when we are going to update the value of 3, 4 depending on the value of 3, 1 and 1, 4. So this is the type of communication happening here. So when we divide the data and give it to different processes, what we need to do is we have to broadcast that particular information to other processes as well. For that, what we are going to do is during the iteration K, every task in that particular column must broadcast its value to the other task in the same row. And again, during the iteration K, what we have to do is every task in a row must broadcast its value to the other task in the same column. So this is the communication, or this is the type of broadcasting that happens in Floyd's algorithm. Now the third step, agglomeration and mapping. You can see that the number of tasks is definitely static because we have the predetermined number of weights. Communication among the tasks is always structured and the computational time is also constant. So definitely the strategy would be agglomerate the task to minimize the communication and map one task per one MPI process. Now, what are the choices for data decomposition? How to divide that matrix? Either we can divide the matrix row wise or column wise. Here you can see the two types of data decompositions for matrices. In a row wise block strip decomposition, each process is responsible for a continuous group of rows. Here you can see there are 11 rows which are divided among three processes. Now in the second figure, in a column wise block strip decomposition, each process is responsible for a continuous group of columns. Here, there are 10 columns which are divided among three processes. Here, we will compare the two decomposition. When you see that the column-wise block stripped, the broadcasting within the column is actually eliminated. And in again, row-wise block stripped decomposition, the broadcast within the row is eliminated. But still, in a column-wise stripping, we have to broadcast among the row. And again, in row-wise stripping, we have to broadcast among the column. But here, there is one advantage for row-wise block stripping. That is because of many programming languages use row major order in the memory allocation. You can see that whenever a two-dimensional array is stored in C memory, it is in the order of row major. Hence, we can choose the row-wise block strip decomposition here. We will summarize the entire slide here. We have seen the parallel version of Floyd's algorithm. We started with the partitioning. Each point in the adjacency matrix becomes the task here. Now, regarding communication, we know that to compute I, j, we need the minimum value of I, j and the comparison of I, k plus k, j. So we need to have a row broadcast and also a column broadcast. Finally, we have decided to go for row-wise matrix decomposition since many of the programming languages choose row major decomposition. Finally, mapping according to our decision tree, we can choose to agglomerate the task to minimize the communication. So we'll be seeing the next case study in the next slide.